Brahmanandam paramasukadam kevalam gyanamurtim dvandvatitam gagana sadrisham tattvamasyadilaksham ekam nityam vimalam achalam sarvadi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarayitam sadgurum tam namami Sadgurum tam namami. I bow to the Guru, who is the embodiment of bliss of Brahman, the giver of the greatest beatitudes, the absolute, the personification of highest knowledge, who is beyond the pairs of opposites, like pains and untouched by evil, like the sky, who is indicated by the scriptures as thou art that. He is one without a second, the eternal, the pure, the immovable, the witness of all mental modifications, abiding ever beyond thoughts and attributes. I bow down to my Guru. Om, peace, peace, peace be unto all. This morning our subject is on Guru. Last Sunday was Guru Purnima, which was called Vyasa Purnima, Ashadi Purnima. This Guru Purnima is widely observed in the northern part of India. Let me tell you a little bit background of this Guru Purnima. On this particular day, Vyasa was born. Without Vyasa, we cannot think of Vedanta and Hinduism. He compiled the four Vedas. And to explore the mystery of the Upanishads, he wrote Brahma Sutra, which is called Vyasa Sutra, Shariraka Sutra. There are many names are there of that famous book. Then, to propagate this religion, righteousness, philosophy, morality, ethics, he wrote the Mahabharata, the greatest epics in the whole world, 100,000 verses. And Gita is included in the Mahabharata, which is the quintessence of Vedanta. Then Vyasa wrote 18 Puranas, which disseminated the religion to the masses through stories. So on the Vyasa's birthday, many sages from different places came to pay tribute to him. Then Vyasa said, I'm glad that all of you have come, but you know it is not necessary for you to come to pay homage. Let me tell you, I am a guru, and I shall enter all gurus in the world on this particular day. They call it Jnana Guru. We first get knowledge from our parents. Vidya Guru, we go to school, colleges, and get knowledge, that they are called Vidya Guru. Then Diksha Guru, the person who gives initiation for realizing God. So I shall enter all gurus, and if you observe on that day, my birthday, then all will think of me. That was the source, mystery, origin of this Guru Purnima. As I already said, this Guru Purnima is widely observed in the UP, Punjab, the Himalayan region. The monks observe, they think of their guru. But in our Ramakrishna tradition, when I was in India, we never observed this Guru Purnima. It is the latest development. I left, of course, India in 1971. No Guru Purnima. But now, President, Vice President, and the Djiboutis come to pay respect to their gurus. It is the latest tradition has been introduced. The Djiboutis come to the monastery to pay respect to their gurus. It is good for them. We are taught that Ramakrishna is the guru and is the Ishta. Sri Ramakrishna could not bear these three words, Guru, Karta, Baba. He said, when I hear those three words, the thorns pricks my body. But strange enough, Mathur used to call Sri Ramakrishna Baba. Baba means father. And Shomu Mallik used to call Sri Ramakrishna Guruji. Sri Ramakrishna scolded him. I am not your guru, you are my guru. Sri Ramakrishna could not stop these two devotees. And Karta means master. Sri Ramakrishna said again and again, Satchidananda is guru. That consciousness which removes the ignorance, that is the guru. That is the Shakti, Guru Shakti. We shall talk about it, about Guru Shakti. The person who removes, destroys the bondage of worldliness of the people, he is the guru. In that connection, Sri Ramakrishna told a story of a real guru and adept guru and inadept guru. He said, one day I was going to Pine Grove in Dakshineshwar, and I heard a frog was croaking. So I went forward and then found a water snake grabbed a frog. And the snake cannot swallow it, or nor it can give it up. So both are in pain. The frog was in pain, and the snake was in pain. So he said, there are some inadept gurus, they take the responsibility of their disciples. The guru suffers, and the disciple suffers. But if that frog is bitten by a cobra, in one or two croaks, the frog dies. That is the adept guru. That is the way Sri Ramakrishna explained two kinds of guru. Then he told another parable that guru gives a mantra. In that connection, he told the parable of the pearl oyster. Pearl oyster floats on the surface of the water. Then when the Shwati star ascends, the rain falls into that polished, inside the oyster, and it closes the shell, and then goes it deep into the ocean, and the bottom of the ocean, and then it, through gyration, it forms a pearl. So take the mantra and dive deep within and repeat it. Then you will find God. We shall talk more about it when we will continue our lecture. But sometimes, of course, Sri Ramakrishna said there are three types of guru. One kind, the first class, he forces disciple. Another, only gives instruction and keeps in touch, and another just gives instruction and the disciple, guru does not inquire about the disciple. But I like Swamiji's attitude. Swamiji says some gurus ruin their disciples. They ask them, hang on me, hang on me. They will never, never grow. Love and freedom, these are the two conditions of growth. Swamiji said that if you teach them how to swim, let them swim. If you do not teach your children how to drive, then you will have to be a chauffeur all through your life. That is Swamiji's attitude. Teach them how to stand on their own feet, take their own responsibility. Finally, the mind becomes the guru. I like that attitude. Meaning of the word guru. According to Guru Gita, Gushabdascha andhakara syat rushabdasta nirodhaka andhakara nirodhatvat guru iti obhidiyate. Gu means darkness, ignorance. Ru means remover, destroyer of that darkness. Means ignorance. That person is the guru. There are many kinds of guru, tantric guru, those who teach tantra sadhana, puranic guru, regular religious tradition. This is a guru parampara, guru to disciple, guru to disciple. According to our tradition, Adi Guru is Brahma, the creator. He gave the knowledge to his son Vasishtha, Vasishtha to Shakti, Shakti to Parashara, Parashara to Vyasa, Vyasa to Shukadeva, Shukadeva to Gaudapada, Gaudapada to Govindapada, and Govindapada to Shankara. Then came 10 sects of Shankara's Vedantic monks, Giri, Puri, Parbat, Ashram, Aranya, Born Parbat. So as you know, Sri Ramakrishna's guru was Totapuri, one of the monks of the Shankara's order. So we are also in that sect, Guru Parampara. Now the traditional guru has both good side and the bad side. What is the good side? The guru knows that your family tradition, perhaps you are the follower of Rama, you are the follower of Krishna, you are the follower of Shakti, Mother. So the guru gives mantra according to their tradition, their family tradition. That is a good thing. And bad thing, suppose I'm talking about hereditary guru. My father was the guru of your father. I am the guru of you. My son will be guru of your son. In this way, hereditary guru tradition comes, guru system. The problem is sometimes in the guru's tradition, perhaps the one of the guru is a businessman or has a job, and guru initiation is a part-time profession, income. I still remember in Hollywood on Wednesdays we have gospel class. Christopher Isher would read half an hour and the Swamis would answer questions half an hour. When Swami Prabhupada was sick, I used to answer questions. So one day, Christopher Isharu did not come, an actress was reading the Gospel of Ramakrishna. And he read, Sri Ramakrishna said, Guru Giri, meaning guru business, is just like a prostitution. She was very upset. She was telling me, Swami, our Swamis are the gurus, but they are not prostitutes. And I also teach foreign students. I am not a prostitute. Then I explained to her what Sri Ramakrishna meant. He meant, generally, the prostitute wants more customers, more money. So this kind of family guru, tradition of our, they want more disciples, then means he has more income. In that context, Sri Ramakrishna said, guru business is a kind of prostitution. Anyhow, that was in Hollywood. In the Guru Gita, we find Ajnana Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama. When we have cataract, we go to a doctor. He takes the laser or some instrument and remove the cataract from the eyes and gives us clear vision. Similarly, the Guru removes the cataract, means darkness, ignorance, from the eyes of the disciples, so that they can, through the collirium of knowledge, so that they can have the vision of God. That is the traditional way we understand the Guru's job. He removes ignorance. In Munduka Upanishad, we read, Tad vijnanartam sa gurume vavai gatshet samitpani shrutriyam brahmanishtam. A disciple goes to the Guru with samitpani, with sacrificial fagot, wood in their hands. That means shraddha, faith. Shrutriyam brahmanishtam, those are the two words about the qualification of Guru, Shrotriyo. He has the knowledge of the scriptures, so he can know what is the truth. Brahmanishtam, that means that person has the conviction. He has no doubt about Brahman, about God. We shall talk more about this Guru's science a little later. So, Shangshar Dabanal. This whole world is just like a frying pan. We are tossed, burned from desires and doubts. In the Bibhiku Chudamani, the disciple went to the Guru and said, O Guru, how could I cross this ocean of Maya? What should be my goal? What is the way? I know none. Be gracious. Tell me how to end the miseries of the earthly life. This is a beautiful way the disciple approached the Guru. Then the Guru answered, O prudent one, do not fear. For you there is no danger. There is a way to cross the ocean of worldly life. I shall tell you that method by which sages have reached to the other shore. Human life is very precious. Manushyattam. These three things are rare. Human life, mumukshyattam, desire for liberation, mahapurusha sankshaya, a company of a great soul. If you have these three, remember, you are on the right track. What we need? Shraddha, bhakti, and dhyana, meditation. Shraddha, faith, bhakti, love, devotion, and meditation. These are the three ways the disciple should move forward in the spiritual life. Mahapurusha Sangha. It is very, very important to have association with the Guru. Sangha. In this country, you people are lucky that you can have communication, connection with Guru. In India, not possible. Each Swami, some Swamis have 40, 50, 100, 100,000 disciples. It is very difficult to give personal touch with everybody. But they say that, you know, Thakur is there, and if you have any problem, ask questions, and you read the Gospel of Ramakrishna, and you have wonderful literature, for example, Paramartha Prasanga, Towards the Goal Supreme, A Guide to Spiritual Life. Those books will help you to answer many of your questions. Sangha. Sangha doesn't mean you will have to live in the same room with your guru. Sangha means to translate the teachings of the guru in your life. That is called real Sangha. Look, Sri Ramakrishna is the incarnation of God. There are so many people in Dakshineswar. Saw Sri Ramakrishna. The temple officials, they ate with Sri Ramakrishna, they lived with Sri Ramakrishna, they saw day and night Sri Ramakrishna. But you do not see any transformation in their lives. Sangha, the physical vicinity, is not enough. Before you accept anybody as your guru, check him. As Sri Ramakrishna says, sadhu ke dine dekhbi, rate dekhbi, tabe sadhu ke vishwas karibi. See the guru bank at the daytime and night time, and then trust him. Don't make a quick decision to accept anybody as a guru. Don't go to a quack doctor or a quack dentist. They can ruin your life. Check your friends and select a good doctor, a good dentist. Similarly, before we accept anybody as your guru, check around. There's a big spiritual supermarket in America. Shankara used four words, Shrutriyo, Abhrijino, Akamahato, Brahmavittama. These are the four signs of a true guru. Shrutriya means he knows the inner meaning, outer meaning of the scriptures, and he practices what he teaches. Abhrijino, his character must be pure. An immoral person cannot be a spiritual teacher. That is the difference between a brilliant orator and professor and a spiritual teacher. A professor may be brilliant in his subject and he can give you wonderful teachings, but his character may not be good. That person cannot be a spiritual teacher. Abhrijino, akamahato, desireless. He will not ask anything from you. Brahmavittama, his mind is established in Brahman. Similarly, the disciples' signs have been mentioned in Upadesha Shavastri by Shankara. Prashanta chitta, he is very calm, disciplined mind. Jitendriya, he has control over the senses. He has control over lust and anger, free from lust and anger, and humble, and mumukshu, burning desire for liberation. Such a student should approach to a Nuara Brahman guru for lesson. In Shita Shutra Upanishad also we find Yasya Devi Para Bhukti Yatha Devi Tatha Guru. As you have faith, love and devotion for your guru, same you should have for the Ishta. When these two things become one, then the truth reveals within. Some people try to think that everything of Advaita Guru and myself are the same. Shankara cautioned, Baba Advaitam Sada Kurjat. Think about Advaita, non-dual, that I am Brahman. But don't try to adopt that method with your Guru. Oh Guru, you and myself both are the same. Shankara cautioned. If you love your Guru, he will pour more and more his wisdom to you. One day in Dakshineshwar, he was crying for God. Sri Ramakrishna came, just, I think near the Panchabhuti. He says, "Besh, besh, very good. Dekho, ekchu kuchu korle, keu ise bole debe, ei ei koro. If you start your spiritual journey, then somebody will come and tell you, do this next, do this next, do this next. You must make an effort first, then help will come. Guru will come." Some people come and say, "Oh, you are my guru, please do everything for me." It does not work that way. Uddharet atmanatmanam natmanam abhasadayet. Raise yourself by yourself. Don't yield to depression. Your disciplined mind is your friend. Your indisciplined mind is your enemy. Krishna mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Guru can cook food for you, but you will have to eat it. If you do not eat, you will starve. Guru cannot put your food into your mouth. Some people do not have love and shraddha for the Guru. They take mantra and they go away. One day I was talking to Swami Adi Sharanaji in New York. Maharaj, some people take initiation and go away. Sometimes it hurts, they leave. Then he made a joke. He said, "Look, in this country, some people change husband, change wife, and change guru. What is wrong?" I smiled. Approach is extremely important. As Krishna mentioned, tadbiddhi pranipatena puriprasnena sevaya upadikshanti te gyanam gyaninas tattadurshina. Tattadurshi gyani will teach you. How? You must be humble, pranipat. You must be, you must approach to the guru with humility. Then you ask questions. Puriprasna, and then seva, you must serve your guru. Service to guru is very important. But how can I serve you? Follow what the guru said. Everybody cannot give physical service to the guru. Sometimes here people come, I ask them, "Come here on Saturday, give some service to the center. Vacuum the shrine, chapel. Do give some service, at least a couple of hours a week. That will make you feel that I am connected with the place of the master and I am giving some service to the master. You will feel good." I always encourage people to come to the center and give some service. It is extremely important. That is where you will be acquainted with your guru and the place more. There is a funny story. Swami Sharadananda said, once a guru told his disciple, whose name was Gurudash. Gurudash means the servant of the guru. "Gurudash, it is 10 o'clock. Will you go to the village and bake some fruit food?" "Guru, you asked me to repeat mantra. How can I go?" So Guru went to the village and brought food. Guru then he came and said, "Gurudash, I brought some rice and other things. Will you be able to cook?" "Gurudev, I am now repeating a mantra." Then Guru said, Guru then cooked. And then "Gurudash, will you be able to come and eat now?" "Gurudev, twice I denied you, how disobeyed you, how can I do? I cannot disobey you anymore." So he came and ate food. Nowadays, the disciples are like this. Swami Sharadananda told this story. Funny. Nowadays, gurus are many, and his disciples are very few. Swami Adi Sharanda Ji used to say, perhaps in every corner in New York Street, you will find a guru seated there. And nowadays, YouTube is the guru. All gurus, their biographies, their lectures and classes, all you will find in YouTube. They put me inside there too. YouTube guru. I call it Google guru. Any kind of news, information you want, just Google it. You will get it. So now the modern technology and this, they are taking the position of the guru. You can learn many things from the website. It is very difficult to be a guru, especially in this country. I had a hippie disciple, I remember. She said to me, Swami, if you say any word against Elvis Presley, I shall leave you. You cannot just scold, you cannot discipline, the boy will be angry, some will leave. Very sensitive ego. I remember a Vaishnava saint, Kathiyadas Baba, in Vrindavan. An living soul used to live in a cottage. Still, Kathiyadas Baba Ashrama is in Vrindavan. So, Tarakishur, he was a famous lawyer, a very rich person. He felt renunciation and left home and went to this Kathiyadas Baba to be his disciple. Kathiyadas Baba just kicked on his chest and pushed him away. And he fell down. Then again he came back. I know you want to break my ego, but I shall not leave you. You are my guru. That Tarakishwar, I think Chaudhary. Later on he became Shantadas Babaji, a great saint. You see, if you do that kind of thing in this country, you will be sued. Well, a disciple abuse. Guru is just like a farmer. He sows the seed mantra in the heart of his disciples. I sometimes say, Guru's job is to put the mantra in the heart, and you have three jobs. First, irrigation. You will have to water that seed every day, twice a day, morning and evening. Irrigation, that is means devotion to God, devotion to your mantra. Second, weeding. When you give water, some other bushes may cover your seed, your plant. So you must discriminate. Remove all other worldly thoughts from your mind. Let your mantra grow. Third, if you want to expedite your mantra, you need passion, longing, yearning. That I call it fertilizer. If you give fertilizer, the plant grows faster. There is a story about Buddha. There is a Brahmin named Bharadwaj. He told Buddha, I am a farmer. I plow and sow. That is the way I get my harvest. Buddha says, I am also a farmer. I shall read that passage to you. That it is a beautiful passage. Look what Buddha said. Faith is the seed I sow. Devotion is the rain. Majesty is the plow shaft. The mind is the tie of the yoke. Mindfulness is my plowshare and goad. Energy is my team and bullock. Leading to safety and proceeding without backsliding to the place where there is no sorrow. Hearing this, Bharadvaj became the disciple of Buddha. I was talking about Guru Shakti. Guru Gita says, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwara, Guru Reva Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama. Guru is Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, and Supreme Brahman. And I bow down to that Guru. Now the question arises about the human Guru. Is the human Guru is Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara? No, but the Shakti, the power, which is within the human Guru, it comes from God, comes from the Divine Mother. Let me give some examples, then you will understand better. You get water, I get water from where? From the Mississippi River. The city takes the water from the Mississippi River, they refine it, and they process it, and then distribute in every home in the city. The my faucet water, your faucet water are coming, the source, Mississippi River. Mississippi River is God, and the faucet water is the human Guru. Same thing electricity. The immersion electric generates electricity, and distributes whole city. So if I need electricity, I go to my outlet and the plug point and put it there and I get light. The source is the dynamo where they generate electricity. That is God. And the outlets in the home, they are all human gurus. Swami Bhutishanandaji used to say about human guru, it is just like a pratima, puja. We have the image of Durga or Kali or Krishna. We worship the image, thinking that God is in that image. Then the worship is over, then we immerse that image. So human guru is like that. We impose the Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara on human being. And then, when Guru dies, Guru becomes one with Ishta. That's Sri Ramakrishna says. Sheshe Guru Ishte Loy Hoy. Finally, the Guru merges with Ishta. So, when Guru dies, do not cry. Swami Vishuddhananda Ji used to tell that I am like a matchmaker. He was a great sadhu. He was a Holy Mother's disciple. He used to say, when a disciple comes to be initiated, I take the disciple and connect Sri Ramakrishna, we connect with the master, with Sri Ramakrishna, and I connect them. That is my job, through a mantra. I am a matchmaker, that he used to say. Shaktipat. The guru transmits shakti, power, through the mantra. When you read the lives of the avatars, we see they had gurus. Krishna's, Ramchandra's guru was Vasishtha, Krishna's guru was Sandipan, Buddha had guru, those five Brahmins. Then Jesus had guru, John the Baptist. Shankar had guru, Govindapath. Chaitanya had guru, Keshav Bharati. Ramakrishna had several gurus. Even the avatars had gurus. Seeing their humans, seeing their superhuman powers, human beings believed that this person is God. Jesus is God, Krishna is God, Ramakrishna is God. That human being has become God. The manifestation of Shakti, the divine power manifested through these avatars, that we see. You are not human, you are God. this exalted power by which the Divine Mother removes ignorance and delusion from human minds is called Guru Bhava or Guru Shakti. Please don't forget this sentence. It is the Divine Mother's power comes to these human gurus to show the way to God to human beings. So guru is just like a medium. One day Sri Ramakrishna asked his young disciple, Subodhananda, Khoka Maharaj, "Hey, your home is very close to M's house. Why don't you go to him time to time?" "Oh, sir, he's a householder. He has wife and children. What does he know about God? I shall come to you." Sri Ramakrishna says, "No, no, no, no. He will talk about me. You go to him." So he, Khoka Maharaj, went to, very simple. He went to M and said, "Sir, I have come to you. Sri Ramakrishna sent me to you. And I told this thing to Sri Ramakrishna." He is very frank. What he said to Sri Ramakrishna, that he said to M. M said, "You are right." M is the recorder of the Gospel of Ramakrishna. "Those who come to me, I do not give my water to them. I give them Ramakrishna's water. I only tell them about Sri Ramakrishna. I do not know anything else." That is the Shakti. The Shakti path, it is in Christian tradition. If you read the Bible in the chapter on Acts of the Disciple, when Jesus departed, the Pentecost, that divine, the power descended on the disciples. Through that they started to show miracles. So one day Peter was going to the church. A born lame asked Peter, "Please heal my this condition." Then Peter said, "Gold and silver have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And immediately his lameness was gone. He started to walk. Then people are marveled. Then that lame man says that Peter did it, healed my lameness. Then Peter says, "Not I, but the Father in heaven." That is called Shakti path. That Shakti comes to the disciples. Sri Ramakrishna transmitted power to his disciples. He transmitted power to Swamiji. I remember another incident. Swamiji asked Birajananda and Prakashananda to go to Dhaka to preach. Birajananda says, "What do I know that I shall preach?" "Well, go and tell them that you do not know anything. That would be a great preaching." Then he asked Swami Prakashananda. Swamiji took Prakashananda's hands and shook, "Go!" But I felt Swamiji transmitted power within me. You know, they are great teachers. They have a great power to transmit that Guru Shakti. As manifestation of God's power, all gurus are the same. I remember once a disciple of Prabhavananda came to St. Louis, and we had a disciple, Prasad Prakashananda, and they had fight. Who is great? Prabhavananda is great or Swami Sat Prakashananda is great? Funny. To me, my guru is the greatest. If to you, your guru is the greatest. But as you remember Sri Ramakrishna's that beautiful story. The followers of Vishnu and followers of Shiva had fight. Who is great? So Padmalochan was the umpire. He asked the followers of Vishnu, have you seen Vishnu? No. Your father? No. Your grandfather? No. Then he asked the followers of Shiva, have you seen Shiva? No. Your father, grandfather? No, no. Then how do you know who is the great? Then he said, the followers of Krishna, followers of Vishnu, to them, Vishnu is the greatest. Followers of Shiva is the greatest. First realize God, then he will understand they are the same. Swami Satprakashananda asked Swami Sivananda, Maharaj, some people get initiation from Holy Mother and some from Brahmananda. Is there any difference? No difference. Same Ganges water is coming through different faucets. Same Sri Ramakrishna Shakti is coming through these two channels. No difference. I told this story to a Swami, Swami Nitya Sarupananda. He put me a counter question. But Chetanananda, all faucets, all pipes are not the same. Some are half inch diameter, some are quarter inch, some are three quarters, some are 1 inch, some are 2 inches, some are 4 inches. There is a difference of diameters of the pipe, water pipe. I couldn't give an answer, but yesterday I got an answer. Do you know how I felt? If you are bitten by a big cobra, you will die. And if you are bitten by a small cobra, you will die. The poison is very effective. That is the answer. Shakti, the Guru Shakti, is the same. Mannatho Shri Jagannatho, Madguru Shri Jagadguru, Mamatma Sarvabhutatma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. My Lord is the Lord of the world. My Guru is the Lord of the world. And my soul is the soul of all beings. I bow down to that Guru. One day Swamiji asked my first disciple, Sadananda, hey Gupta, if you get a better guru than me, will you leave me? Of course, sir. You are my true disciple, Swamiji said. But Sadananda said, but I shall never get a better guru than you, Swamiji. Diksha. According to Tantra, diyate gyanam kshiyate pushubhasana iti diksha. Diyate gyanam. Initiation is very vital in spiritual life. It will give you the knowledge and it will destroy your animal desires. Jesus also told the parable of the swine that sometimes if you throw the seeds, it may some fall on the stone, it will not germinate. It falls into bushes, it will be suffocated and it will die. But if the seed falls in the good soil, it will grow. Similarly, the Guru gave the mantra, but if the mantra is not properly cultivated, you will not get the result. That is it. Preparation is very, very important. Sometimes I ask people when they are approaching initiation, I can read some Ramakrishna's life, Holy Mother's life, attend our lectures and classes, see whether you like it or not. If you like it, we shall initiate. Preparation. Na bahun shishan kurbita. Don't make too many disciples, scripture says. And Gita also says, those who are not disciplined, those who do not practice austerity, those who are not have no devotion, those who are not humble or serving, have no serving attitude, And those who do not care for God, hate God, don't teach this Gita to them. Mantra. Some people think mantra is a very, it's mere words. No, don't think that way. Mantra is very, very powerful. God and His name are identical. I remember some children in Balaram's house requested Brahmananda, Maharaj, you give mantra to the people, why don't you give mantra to us? Maharaj was making fun with them. Hey, I have all kinds of mantra. I have China mantra, Japanese mantra, German mantra, British mantra, American mantra. Which mantra do you want? Maharaj used to make fun with the children. Does mantra work? It works. I remember a couple wanted initiation from me. Husband was a doctor. I said, no. They're in Europe. I said, you go to Swami Bhuteshanandaji and he will initiate you. Just tell my name. So they took initiation from Bhuteshanandaji in Bedunmaj. Then after a few months, his wife called me and said, Swami, something happened. Uncle, what happened? Swami, before initiation, we used to quarrel. But nowadays, we are not quarreling at all. Then I said, just see, mantra works. Mantra stopped quarreling and bickering in the house. Holy Mother told Krishna Lal Maharaj, you know, some people take initiation and come and complain, I have no peace of mind. They complain and complain and complain. Let them repeat mantra 15 to 20,000 times a day. Let me see whether their mind will come under control or not. It is bound to come down. It is bound to be calm. Krishna Lal, I did it, and it works. Holy Mother experimented and verified and told his disciples, it will work. And nowadays, I sometimes say, try 3 days, I shall repeat mantra 15, 20,000 times a day. 3 days. I assure you, we are not going to die. Repeating mantra, a person does not die. Maybe 5, 6 hours, 7 hours, you can repeat mantra, morning 1 hour, give a break, another hour break, in this way, read in between, eat less, do some sadhana by yourself. See whether it works or not. It works. Good. I remember another story. Holy Mother told Swami Gyanananda. He's a young boy, 17, 18 years old, came from Dhaka to Jayarambhaji. From Dhaka to Jayarambhaji. Holy Mother said, hey, Gyan, stay here and do my errands. Mother was fond of that young boy. And he was a hard worker. Then one day mother said, Gyan, could you bring some flowers from the bank of the Amudar River? So he brought some flowers. Come inside my room. Mother took him to his room, to her room, and initiated him. And said, now bow down to the master. He is your guru. Oh, no, he is not my guru. You are my guru. You gave me the mantra. No, I am not your guru. Thakur is guru. Thakur is ishta. Thakur is your all in all. No, you cannot be my mother. My mother is in Dhaka. Look, I am your mother. Immediately, Holy Mother took his mother's form, and he saw and he was overwhelmed. Thakur is the guru, Thakur is the ishta. That's a beautiful story. about Guru Dakshina. I remember in 1960s and 70s, Maharshi Mahesh Yogis, Transcendental Meditation, all over the Western world, my goodness, GM. They were selling mantra $125. So I was asking Sai Prabhupada, Maharaj, Guru Dakshina, how much do you charge from your disciples? He said, I take a flower. I said, no, Maharaj, you must charge a fruit. When I initiate, I tell them, I need 1 dozen flowers and 2 fruits. Of course, some people give some money also. In India, you have to give cloth and chador and fruits and sweets and all those things. I made the thing simple. 2 fruits, 1 for Guru, 1 for Ishto. But let me tell you my story. I had no money. And Advaita Ashrama cannot give any money for rituals. So one of my friends, Brahmachari, he asked a devotee and got 2 rupees for me. So 1 rupee I gave Dakshina, and 1 rupee I bought 8 anas fruits and 8 anas sweets. And of course, Belur Math gave the flower. I was initiated on Good Friday, 1961, by Swami Shankarananda ji. Anyhow. So after initiation, I came to my mentor, Swami Bodhatmananda, and asked Maharaj. Maharaj was asking me, have you given Dakshina? I told him, yes, I gave Dakshina. Well, what did you give? Well, I gave 1 rupee. No, you did not give the Dakshina. Dakshina means as a token, as some offering you are supposed to give to the Guru after initiation. So he said, no. Then he explained what is real Dakshina. The mantra which Guru put in your heart today, that mantra will take that seed mantra will take a form of a plant and tree, and it will bloom and the fruit. When that fruit comes, that you offer to the Guru. That is called real Guru Dakshina. That means God realization. Anyhow, Guru is essential in spiritual life. Acharyavan Purusho Veda. Chandogya Upanishad says, the person who has a teacher, only he knows God. Some people think that we can learn about spiritual life from books. It does not work. You cannot be a doctor reading the books. You will have to go to medical school. You cannot be a surgeon by reading the Grey's Anatomy, knowing that you cannot operate a gallbladder or open heart surgery just reading a books. You need a guru. Swami Brahmananda used to say, even if you want to be a pickpocket, you need a teacher so that you may not get caught. In the West, some people think through books I shall be spiritual. Just think of that before you got your B or MA degree, how many teachers you had in your life. I sometimes say this mantra is just like a stamp on the envelope. When you write a letter on the envelope, you stick a stamp, and then you drop in the mailbox, it will go to its destination. Similarly, the mantra Guru gave to you, hold on, it will take you to God. Swami Brahmananda used to say, practice what I said for 3 years sincerely. If you do not get the result, come and slap on my face. My goodness, I shall not go so far. Swami Vigyananda ji used to say, you know, I can initiate you on condition. What is your condition? You promise that you will not write me any letter. No complaint. Follow the instructions of your guru. The Guru Gita says, Dhyanamulam Gurur Murti, Pujamulam Gurur Padam, Mantramulam Gurur Vakyam, Mokshamulam Gurur Kripa. Meditate on the form of your Guru. Worship your Guru. The Guru's words are the mantras. As Amy used to say, every word of Sri Ramakrishna in the gospel is a mantra. Moksha mulam Guru's kipa, Guru's grace will give you liberation. Always remember, Diksha Guru is only one, cannot be many. Shiksha Guru may be many. Obviously, there are 24 gurus. You can learn from many other things from many people. But about spiritual life, your mantra, your guru, and ishto, these three things are vital. Do not deviate from it. And follow what his guru said. Dig in one place. I know a person, he took initiation from three places. Sri Ramakrishna said, dig one place, otherwise he will never get water. Anyhow, I tried to cover some ideas about guru and our tradition on this. People are asking, Swami, on Guru Purnima, you must give a talk on the guru. I tried. And then now I shall go and answer your questions through Zoom. Om Satoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya Abhirabhirma Yedi Rudra Jatte Dakshinamukam Tinamam Pahi Nityam Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Lead us from the unreal to the real. Lead us from darkness to light. Lead us from death to immortality. Light us through and through, and guide us evermore with thy loving presence. Om, peace, peace, peace be unto all.